Hi everybody, welcome to our new video. Today we're going to show you how to install to fix the error from MySQL. So this is the error. So whenever I try to look sudo service MySQL start, I'm trying to put MySQL start, it tells me failed to start MySQL.service. Unit mysql.service not found. That's what they tell us. So what are we gonna do? So we're gonna do something simple. We're gonna do this. We're going to reinstall MySQL. We're gonna install MySQL server and client. Let's see. That's what we've done. Let's see if it's gonna work for us. If it works for us, then guys, we're gonna be good to go. Okay, let's give it some time. Once it works, then we okay. Okay, we're still waiting and see. Okay, let's be patient. It's still doing its thing. Give it a chance, let's give it a chance and wait. We see it's a matrix 100% done. Update alternatives using this and this and that. It should give us the screen we're looking for. Okay. Processing trigger main DB. Wow, that is done. Let's try to see if this is gonna work. Remember, we're gonna recall one command here. Say MySQL start. So simply means it worked, guys. So that's the challenge I was facing, and also I wanted to go here and find this one of my problems which I had. I'm gonna recall one of the commands here. Please get that command work. Let me say enter. Okay, my problem was simple. I wanted to run MySQL, what they call SQL. Let me get it here. Localhost. Localhost. Okay. PHP my admin. That's what I wanted to run. Then I got into problems. Then I didn't have a database. Then I'm using root. Then this is root. Then I tried to log in. Then I get some problems, some issues. That's the reason why I did do that. But anyway, if you find the same problem, so I'm trying to do this, then give me a password, which is gonna be root. If you find the same problem, so do what I'm telling you to do. So now once you find that problem, so you know what to do now. So I'm gonna create what they call another username, another password, you get me, so that I'll be able to access what I want to access. So the username and password, I'm gonna use password to be root, and the username here I'm gonna use MUSA. Let me use the same thing, let's say MUSA, and I'm gonna copy this and I'll create it here, and after that I say enter. Okay, two rows affected. Then I'm gonna say MUSA, then I say, but sometimes you have to restart the server. Okay, wow, this was created and I don't have any issues anymore. I have some little issues, configuration storage is not complete, confirm some extensions, whatever features has been, whatever. So anyway, that is something for another day, but I managed to get my what working, my logged into my PHP my admin, and that's fine. Okay, so that is simple. I'm gonna cancel that and I'm gonna close this, guys. No, let me not close, let me cancel. Just see, this is the problem I was facing, and I believe the problem is solved. So whatever I want to do, I can do it anytime. So I faced two errors, which I'm gonna put into the description below so that you can see it. First of all, the reason why we're doing this, we did not have MySQL server, we had the client, you get me. So since we had the client, that's why we're gonna find, like, okay, command sudo not found, then we try to run this command, whatever, then it could show us error 2 or whatever, you can't connect to local MySQL through socket. That's what it was telling me. But then I try to do what? I try to say, okay, that's fine. The reason was because we did not have what? A MySQL server on our own what machine. That's why you see that when I did try to, then when I discover this, I say, okay, that's a problem. So let me do what? Let me go and connect to, let me go and do what? And restart the server. When I try to start service MySQL start, then it was giving me another error which says failed to start MySQL service. Then you say unit MySQL service not found. So you can see that this was also another error when I start this. So that's when I realized that I don't have what MySQL server. I had the MySQL client. Then I redo it again and again, and also get the same what, the same error. So then I said, wow, what's going on? I tried to read on some tutorials, some scriptures on Google. Then I find that I didn't have the server, I had only the client. So what was my next step? My next step is to what? To install the server. As you can see that we use this command which says sudo apt-get install space minus y, then it says space mysql space server space mysql space dash service dash client. So once we've done that, the packages started installing themselves, and you saw all the problems we found, they were all what, fixed. So after fixing them, then I managed to, I can restart the server, I can start it. So you see everything when it was done, then we went here into the installation process. Then after that, I managed also to create my username and also managed to create my password. Then I'm connected to MySQL. So all other stuff, I'm gonna do what? I'm gonna do them after other problems which came up. So those ones can also be connected or fixed in the another tutorial. But for now, we passed the first stage. So guys, don't forget to subscribe. This is Azania Tutorials. So that problem you have, it's already fixed now. You don't have any issues anymore. See you in the next video. Please do share our content side by side, left, right, and center. Then we're gonna be happy. And also you being a subscriber, it gives us a lot of courage to do more videos. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.